Good morning, my name is Dora Luise and I'm presenting you my abstract on short cycle therapy in HIV-infected adults. So short cycle therapy is a scheme in which HIV-infected patients take their medications instead of 7 days per week, only 5 or 4 days per week with a 2 or 3 days break. Its efficacy and safety has been demonstrated by several trials, the most important of which being the BRADER trial published in 2016 that demonstrated the non-inferiority of short cycle therapy as compared to 7 days a week treatment. The advantages of short cycle therapy are the improvement of quality of life and reduction of costs of antiretroviral therapies. So we conducted a single center of observational studies in our HIV outpatients clinic. Our inclusion criteria were adults with HIV infections in antiretroviral therapy for more than 12 months with at least 12 months of virological suppressions below 50 copies per milliliters, with a CD4 cells count of more than 200 for microliters, and no evidence of drug resistance or failure with the regimens before the beginning of short cycle therapy. Our short cycle therapy schemes was of 4 days on treatment, typically Monday to Thursday, with 3 days break, typically Friday to Sunday. So these are the baseline characteristics of our included patients. We included 33 patients, and these are the most important results. At week 24, we observed no virological failure, although we observed one viral blip. We found that both CD4 cells count and CD4 to CD8 ratios show no significant variations in the period of observations, and no adverse events were reported by the patients, with no significant alterations in their blood analysis. Most of our patients reported to prefer the short cycle therapy over the standard regimens, but 2 patients decided to switch back to 7 days a week regimens for their own convenience. After the end of the study, we actually extended the follow-up to 48 weeks, and our results are again that no virological failure occurred, and another patient decided to switch back to continuous ART. It actually was decided by us after a blip of 136 copies per milliliters attributed to poor adherence at week 36. We reported other 5 viral blips, but all were good blips that allowed the patient to return to viral loads below 50 copies after 4 weeks without therapy changes. So our virological success rate was of 100% with a success rate of the short cycle therapy schemes of 91%. We reported no adverse events and no resistant mutations. So in conclusion, short cycle therapy with 3 drugs, antiretroviral therapy could be a feasible option for optimization of antiretroviral treatment in selected patients, especially in low resource settings. So I would like to thank you for your attention and tell you that please, if you want, feel free to contact me for any further information. Thank you and goodbye.